Hello and welcome back to the Road to Nijmegen campaign. So in the last scenario we were stopped on the Heumann Blockbridge by some kind of secret German weapon fueled by incompetence. So in this one we're back with 30 Corps. And little tactical overview. Now in this case we start actually without our tanks. Instead we have armored cars and one of the infantry companies. And there are four objectives. We don't need all of them, according to the briefing, to win. And this one is the most valuable, for some reason. So my plan is, because, I mean, we know this by now, this road here is probably death. You know, like, all these 30 core scenarios were basically about how this road is, has every gun trained on it. So what I will do is do the obvious thing. Hook through this forest here, behind this cover, and go directly for the valuable objective and then flank into here or maybe here, depending on how the situation develops. I'm not sure what I'm facing, anti-tank guns were mentioned, and yeah, because of that, I mean, obviously there's an anti-tank gun here. I mean, look at this. By now I know this guy's style a bit, and this is where he puts an anti-tank gun. So this is where the fighter bomber will come in the beginning of the round. So, on top of that, what else? Oh yeah, one thing that kind of annoys me is, the infantry, I used them before, okay, this squad is fine. And, some of them are fine, but if you look at them, where are they? Right, these for example don't have their Bren gun anymore, as well as these. Because the gunner is dead or wounded. Now the thing is this, I'm pretty sure in the previous scenarios I saved the Bren guns. I mean, I'm willing to check the tapes, but I'm pretty sure I always try to get them back. So, but now they're gone. And my theory is that their ammunition got resupplied, and that also reset all the soldiers to their standard equipment, so the guys who picked up a Bren gun now don't have it anymore. And that really annoys me, because these are no... I don't want to say useless, but pretty useless at least for fire support, so that's kind of annoying. I hope that, because this is probably the last mission of the first day, and I kind of hope that we also get proper reinforcements during the night, so some of those infantry squads are back up to snuff. Because it feels kind of stupid that I saved these Bren guns and then they apparently gave them away. Okay, so everybody off the road, we know this deal by now. There's probably an anti-tank gun. Oh, actually. Can he actually see into here? Well, we will know when that thing blows up. Okay, here comes my plane. At least this time I don't have to exit them, as far as I know. Just get the objective. Okay, maybe I was wrong and wasted a fighter bomber attack. That being said, these fighter bombers were never as useful as artillery in these scenarios. Okay, I'm hearing pluck. What the fuck? Well, hopefully that knocked out or spooked whoever is in there. If there are people in there, I just assume, to be honest. Another nice thick forest to take cover in. I'm gonna take positions along this tree line and see what checks out. Now my tanks will arrive later, so then I have proper cannons in support. For now, I have these Steckhounds, which have 37mm American anti-tank guns, and Dingoes with 2-pounders. Oh no, do these have canister? Nah, too bad. On average, too, at least in the Africa scenario, the 37 mil can fire canister. Now, obviously, I don't want to advance across this area, but behind this or through this forest would be a nice approach. I don't think that was directed at me, I think that was shot at the plane. Which apparently comes down for another attack. Invisible gunman strikes again. Oh, okay, apparently he had a second bomb. I mean, it kind of looks shit with a stretched texture, but... Now over here I'm moving up my observer team into this hatch line, from which you can see at least that objective quite well. Okay. Made no contact here so far. So I will move up the 3rd Infantry Platoon and they will assault... Well, actually there's a nice dip in the ground. They will assault behind here into this area. And once they're in here I can... at that point if there's anybody in this hatch line, which I assume there is, they will have opened fire. And I can suppress them and maybe drive them off. I deployed my mortars in a way that I might be able to directly fire at them. And yeah, that's kind of the plan right now. What the fuck? Shit, that's a flak gun. Huh. And it actually knocked out the Steckhound, which is, as far as armored cars go, actually pretty well armored. So it's probably a 37mm. Well, nobody was killed apparently, and they popped smoke at least. Now the good thing is, if they keep shooting at this, they might deplete their anti-tank rounds, and then they can't damage... You know, you should probably get away from that thing. And then they can't damage my tank's optics like they did in one scenario. Okay, other than that, not much else going on. Yeah, I keep shooting that, I don't care. Armored cars are disposable to a degree.
Retreat!
Yeah, then do that. And don't hang around that thing that is obviously a target. Some new developments. We got our 2-pounders, Troop A, and we spotted, some German infantry, or paratroopers actually. These are spotted by my, and they're looking back. Probably not a good sign. And they have a Panzerfaust as well. Anyway, so that's German paratroopers, and I already called in the artillery mission. I am 80% convinced that the flak gun that shot at us is somewhere at this hatch line. I mean, look at this. Probably here. Because that would allow it to cover the road here. And also make it relatively hard to attack this objective. So it's probably here, or maybe here. I mean, the specifics aren't important because I'm calling in a fire mission along this line. Okay. On different notes, my infantry is actually coming out of the forest here. And so far not under fire. Now in order to deal with that Fallschirmjäger troop I spotted, let's do the mortar thing. Oh, by the way, another thing regarding ammunition that seems bugged, although in this case I'm not complaining too much. My 25-pounders, according to the briefing, like my off-map assets would be shared between the all the first day missions. So they should be depleted, but they seem to be at full ammo as well, so that's weird. Okay, so, where do the mortars hit? Whoa, my mortars are on point today. That should scare you a bit. That was quick. Quickest mortar ranger ever. Oh, okay, that was a bit further away, but I think there was just natural dispersion. Maybe we'll cause them to flee, but not holding my breath. Over here, still safe, so apparently there's really nobody in this tree line as I had imagined. Where's... is that our more... oh yeah, right. I'm an idiot. Just sounds a bit closer than it should be. Okay, here comes our sacrifice to the gods of spotting, the scout team.
Move it, let's go!
Although I guess this guy kind of exposes himself as well. Once I have this position, I can actually... I can move my infantry through here into... this very valuable objective, the farm. You know, this is a bit weird, I just noticed. It's called watermill, but it's a windmill. I don't think they had a watermill, not static. Static is what it's called in FH2, like prop or building or whatever. Because that looks kind of stupid now. Sort of sent them behind the crest here. You should always check out the terrain from low, from, you know, the low an angle when you give orders to infantry when you're unsure. But they don't seem to be under fire from there. I wonder what the twist is in this scenario. Probably the flak guns, but so far it seems kind of strange. Maybe I could have just driven into that objective, who knows. Yeah, they're not under fire, so I will move the rest of their platoon into here. And then that platoon that still has the Bren guns, that is in Overwatch, will take their positions and they can advance into here. I mean, this is affordable by infantry, obviously. I don't know if I would want to put the armored cars through it, but... yeah. Bommel River. Well, it's more of a creek, really. These guys I will keep behind here, just in case. If I had made this and wanted to make a watermill, I think I would have just... I would have just put a normal building in there, because usually they look like normal buildings, but they have the big wheel. So just leave the wheel out. I mean, it does have this thing here that looks like one of those things that direct the water flow towards the wheel. That's fine. But don't put a windmill there. Although I guess these windmills are kind of very Dutch. I should get the sniper team in here. Ah, it doesn't have a window in that direction. This is another thing, again, I have the sniper team and in the first scenario the sniper got knocked out by the flak gun. And I am 100% sure that his assistant saved the rifle, but now east back to the unscoped one. So my artillery is also being called in. And I gained this tree line. And I'm not under fire from that objective. Wait, that is the objective, right? Yeah, then back to the farm. I wonder if they're, like, the owner of that farm probably is called that, right? I mean, they probably researched that, or... I mean, that's probably the reason a farm has a name like that, because they're not usually, like... They're not usually big campaigns to name farms. Once I mean, I kind of expected to be under fire from here. But if there really is no Germans here, I can pull up the next platoon. Here they come. Put them into Overwatch, because I have the brain guns, and then this platoon will move first here, then here. And then I already have a pretty good grip on the objective, because from there I can gain this hatch line, and whatever is in here has a problem. And then once I have this, the question is, how can I outflank this? Now, this area is swept by the flak gun, obviously, but let's say the artillery takes it out. And even if not, if I have the farm, I can go here, through here, along here. If there's a flak gun here, I can take it out. Of course, wait. Ah, no, that's another farm, so or another objective, Hendrikshove. So it's probably going to be defended, so it's not that easy. But if the flak guns are taken out, I could theoretically rush over infantry here to this hatch line and take out the guys in this foxhole position. Oh! Okay, I was probably a bit over-eager, but yeah, this is guarded, obviously. I mean, come on. Yeah, there we go. Machine gunner here. Now the thing is, I could probably move scout cars over there. Yeah, those are Fallschirmjäger. In their fancy pants camo uniforms. Could probably move scout cars over here for armored support. I mean, they don't really have guns with nice HE value, but still, better than nothing. They have machine guns as well. Let's say... Oh, and there come my spotting rounds. They fired once and then stopped. Probably because these guys took cover. I am moving up my armored cars now. I have to be careful to keep away from these inundated areas here so they don't get stuck. And then the armored cars will be moved up here. I also have the 2-inch mortars, I just realized. So I could probably blindly bombard that a bit and see what shakes out. Artillery keeps ranging in. Probably take a while, but... Never mind, that was pretty good. Oh, sweet. Okay.
Fire.
I think they're fired again. Now this thing at least has a brain gun, which is more than can be said about most of infantry. Well, this guy is. And here comes the strike, huh? Let's hope that causes some casualties here. Yeah? Anyway, that's enough for today. I hope you enjoyed it. As always, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.